20 minutes outside the city of Tallinn is the scenic venue for the 2016 International European Amateur Championship. And not for the first time, the event is being played in a young golfing nation.
We've been playing golf here in Estonia 22 years. And to have an event which is one of the most important amateur events in the world in golf, and to have these players here, it is a big honor. Maybe in 3, 5, 10 years, few of these players are world number ones, and our members and players can see them today.
30 years after the event began, we've traveled to the Baltic coast in northeastern Europe and to Estonia for the most important championship staged by the European Golf Association.
The major role of the EGA is hosting European amateur championships, both individual, men, ladies, seniors, juniors, and also team championships. And of course, promoting the game of golf throughout Europe.
A total of 28 countries are represented in the 144-man field, including Poland.
It's obviously one of the biggest amateur tournaments in the world, so I think every player is looking forward to this tournament every year. All of the players are good enough to be here, so I mean, everyone can win.
Spot in the Open up for grabs if you win, and obviously to say you're European amateur champions, a big deal. So yeah, it's probably one of the kind of majors for us this year.
The defending champion is Stefano Mazzoli, who gained invaluable experience playing in this year's Open at Troon.
The conditions were really tough, but I didn't play great, but I feel like it was an amazing experience, and for sure helped me a lot for everything, for my game, but also staying on the course with some pros helped me out a lot.
On the tee from Italy, Stefano Mazzoli.
He was paired with John Daly and Ben Curtis, and in practice enjoyed Zach Johnson's company.
He came on number 60, and he asked me if he could play with me, and I told him for sure there's no problem.
And there's no problem for the C course at the Estonian Golf and Country Club to measure up as a worthy venue for this championship.
The course is very interesting off the tee. It's pretty narrow off the tee, so you have to keep it straight. Just keep it on the fairway, and then it's much easier, obviously. But the rough around the greens is pretty thick as well, so that makes it a little bit more difficult.
It's playing really soft at the moment, so and the rough's quite thick, so you know, hitting the fairways is quite important, just to have some control. And you know, there's a lot of wedges into greens as well, so that's kind of your biggest birdie chances there, and then just trying to hold some putts.
The powerful Scottish contingent almost missed out on competing, having fallen victim to a traveller's nightmare.
Seven of us actually withdrew from the event, but then they let them back in once the clubs arrived, and there'd been a 2-hour weather delay yesterday. So I think it was a really nice thing to do, because of the situation, and that wouldn't normally happen, I don't think, with some events.
Grant Forrest shot a first round 69 using borrowed clubs, but Kim Thomas, even though he goes into the final 18, 7 off the pace, another Scot is firmly in the mix.
Yes, Phil, that's Glenn Cruton's Robert McIntyre, the feisty left-hander who finished runner-up in the Amateur Championship at Royal Porthcawl. He lies 9 under par after carding scores of 72, 66 and 69. Robbie is 5 shots off the lead. He's 1 ahead of Simon Zak from the Czech Republic. 3 subpar rounds from the Prague resident included some impressive short game displays, like that one. Coolly done. Simple for Simon, you might say. 8 under par, tied 7th after 54 holes.
Eastern Europe going well in general. Poland's Adrian Maronk was a semi-finalist in the Amateur Championship in June, and with rounds of 67, 70 and 70 again, he's impressed. Maronk, a real prospect. Quite surprisingly though, it's not been a productive outing for Mazzoli. He missed the cut, so Ashley Chesters remains the only back-to-back European Amateur Champion. 12 months ago at Panatti, he triumphed at 19 under. This time, rounds of 75, 72 and 76 meant he didn't go the distance.
But inspired by his fellow at Zurich, Luca Cianchetti is looking to keep the trophy in Italian hands. The Modena man is 11 under par, 72, 68, 65, getting better by the day. He's breathing down the neck of a Norwegian teenager called Victor Hovland. The big guy from Miklagard Golf Club has peppered the pins pretty well over the first 3 days. 67, a 73, 4 under at halfway. But he then produced the round of his life on day three. 9 birdies, 9 pars. A fantastic new course record, 63, and it vaults the powerful youngster, Phil, into the lead.
Yes, Hovland leads by 2 from Cianchetti, with 4 golfers tied for 3rd. Marcus Svensson, last year's British boys champion from Sweden, also features on the 54-hole leaderboard. So then to the decisive 18, and starting the final round 5 strokes behind, Simon Zak needed a positive start. That birdie on the 2nd certainly helped. After picking up a shot on the 1st twice before this week, Robert McIntyre completed the hat-trick of opening hole birdies thanks to this chip on the par 5. He immediately moves double digits under par.
First green, Cianchetti's first chance to make a dent into the lead held by Hovland. This for a fabulous eagle on the par 5. Oh, great try. The resultant birdie reduces the deficit, Phil.
Yes, because Hovland made par, so he stays in front, but only by a single shot. As for both Moronk and Thomas Rosenmuller, they run up double bogey 7s on the risk and reward first, slumping back into a tie for 8th.
So let's join the southpaw McIntyre. Second shot on the 350-metre par 4 second. Good for distance. Birdie chance coming right up for the Scot.
Victor Hovland tried to become the 2nd Norwegian to capture this title. In 2005 at Rink Van Golf Club in Belgium, the winner was Marius Thorpe, beating out the likes of Rafael Cabrera Bello, Joost Luiten and a certain Rory McIlroy.
Tee shot on the 5th for Simon Zak, the Louisville Cardinals freshman. 3 bunkers to avoid and a pin to get close to in his case. Great shot.
Ideal drive down the 2nd from Cianchetti, and a pretty good 2nd shot also. The man from Modena, birthplace of Luciano Pavarotti.
And the home of some wonderful balsamic vinegar dressing. Nice brushed in putt there by Zak. He goes to minus 10.
Hovland now. Well, the putting stroke has the fluency of youth. Very nice indeed.
McIntyre's turn next on the 2nd, with a chance to get to minus 11. Green's running well, medium pace. Have to hit these pretty firmly. And it goes. He can play left and right-handed, this young man. He's played the game called Shinty in his youth up there in Oban, in the Highlands.
Now, Zak, we've seen birdies from him on the 2nd and 5th already. What about the 6th? The par 5, a realistic chance. Definitely after that.
Cianchetti should be simple enough, and is 13 under.
Just thinking about Simon Zak, you know, knows how to go low. He was 7th in the English Open amateur stroke play at the London Golf Club. Closing 3 rounds, 270s and a 68. And today, there's no doubt at the moment, the hottest man on the course. Zak, sharing a 7th, teeing off, is now joint 3rd alongside McIntyre. just as he was overnight, the leader of the European Amateur Championship is Victor Hovland, but Luca Cianchetti is also off to a flyer. Golf in Eastern Europe has never been more vibrant, but the region didn't have a representative in the men's competition at the Olympics. That will surely happen in the future, but for now at least, there was a slice of Rio in Estonia.
Quite sure that playing in these events makes you think about the game a bit differently. You see the standard of the play around you, how high it is, and it just makes you want to get better so you can compete.
All right, you're on.
Come on, mate.
Practice was good, so no pressure. Camera's rolling.
On target recently, Slovenia, who beat England in the European boys' team event, and the Czech Republic, winners of the European Young Masters.
Now that's off the green.
I was pretty amazed, to be honest, because I never thought they could beat England. I mean, we all know England is one of the greatest golfing countries. It was a real competitive match play.
Oh, almost got the GoPro.
And yeah, they won at the end, and that's a really big thing for us.
Now we're getting closer.
No.
Oh, almost.
5 points.
For such a small golfing nation like we are, it's very hard to keep producing the players. So that makes me really happy that we have such a young team that's really, really doing well.
Oh, that's just so unlucky.
In Slovenia, there's still such a mentality that golf is just an exclusive sport and all just rich people play it and old people. But I mean, I think that mentality is starting to change right now. You can definitely see that golf is a growing game in Slovenia, and you can see many youngsters starting to play golf.
Whoa. That's a 10.
It's a 10?
That's a
10. Nah, I'm leading.
Leading with a 10 point.
Slovenian Federation has been supportive since I was a little kid, but there has also been struggles. As said before, we are a small nation. That means our budget is not going to be comparable to any other big nations. But as we can see in our, some of the results, especially in younger generations, we are beating bigger nations, and that we can see that golf is evolving.
Hey! First ball, boys! Get in! Czech Republic, that is. That's the winning ball. One is all I need. Thank you.
Thanks, mate. Thank
you. Good game.
Third place, I guess.
Third place, that's still a medal, though.
The Czech Republic standing tall there. And thanks to Simon Zak, that fast-emerging golfing country has a player lying joint third in the European Amateur Championship. But out in front, at the Estonian Golf and Country Club, is Victor Hovland from Norway. One clear of Italy's Luca Cianchetti, and ideally placed off the tee on the short par 4 ninth.
Yep, straight away par 4, and inviting central pin position as well for his second shot here. The 18-year-old, who's going to Oklahoma State University in August. It'll be a big step for him in his golfing and educational career. Good shot there.
The gentleman we've just seen in our feature, Michael Pospisil, missed the cut, so he's caddying for his fellow countryman, Simon Zak. How about the club here on 10?
So it's a 9-iron. Oh, it's a good choice, Phil. That is the ace. Fabulous.
What a shot. Downhill, tough to judge, lovely hole, and the perfect result.
Yeah, and he moves to 13-under in the process. Big move. Great time for an ace.
And what a way to claim a share of the lead.
Back to the ninth then. Cianchetti, he's got to pitch it past the pin if he can. He's managed that. Now stop. Well played. He's hitting it close, awfully often, is the Italian.
If Simon Zak was at home at Erpet Golf Club in Prague, making a hole-in-one with friends, it's a nice feeling. To do it in the final round here, just wonderful.
Amazing shot. Leave it in for you.
Back to that ninth hole again and the birdie chance of McIntyre, 2015 Scottish amateur champion. Straight putt. Got to get the pace, though. Just stopped on him.
Now, this is Connor Syme, who's made only two bogeys in 63 holes this week.
Good birdie.
Two bogeys in 64 holes and a birdie there on 10.
Son of Stuart Syme, professional at Drumoig Golf Centre. Plays off plus 5.1. That's some handicap, isn't it? Now then, Hovland. Birdie putt at 9. Oh, not on that line, Victor. That's a pull. Disappointing. He will stay 13 under.
Which means that Chanketti's putt is for a three-way share of the lead. No issue whatsoever. Two adrift at the start of the day, Chanketti is now in that three-way tie for top spot, with Zak, who reached pole position in truly spectacular fashion, and the overnight leader, Hovland, who's knocked it close on the 10th. He bogeyed 7, but birdied there. So, returning to 14 under.
Simon Zak for birdie on the inviting par 4 12th and 14 under. Invitation accepted. In it goes. This pump back on the 10th. Chanketti for the deuce on the shortest hole on the golf course. Makes short work of it as well. What a superb final day we're having, Phil.
Aren't we just? Receptive greens, low scoring, good fun. There's now a little daylight between the trio at the top and McIntyre in fourth. Zak, Chanketti and Hovland lead the way. And for Chanketti, it only got better because on the 11th, he recorded yet another birdie, his third in succession and fifth of the day. The Italian has climbed to 15 under and leads on his own.
Pin well back on this 13th hole, second shot over the water. The players will like that. No worry about spinning back off the green into the agua. Can he find the distance to the back of the green? Not quite. Simon Zak's attempt.
Chanketti won the South of England Amateur Championship at Walton Heath last year with a third round 66. And I think he's locked into a similar zone here.
He keeps popping it towards the flag, doesn't he? Fantastic stuff. Now, Hovland's reply. Great contest, this. 18 years of age. Hovland from Miklagard Golf Club near Oslo.
Wouldn't it be fantastic for a whole golfing region if Simon Zak could become the first European amateur champion from Eastern Europe? Well, that was a very slow putt up the ridge, and I think he got overbowled on it.
Now McIntyre, uphill shot here, second to the 12th. 12th hole, 340 metres. Oh. Oh. Pin peppered like a Texas beefsteak.
Marcus Svensson, who earlier this year made the cut in the Nordea Masters on the European Tour. Oh, yeah. That presumably one of the reasons why.
Another 18-year-old. Great prospects, these boys. Now then, Chanketti for 15 under. Oh no, he's short. The worst sin of all, not giving it a chance. That would have been four birdies in a row as well.
Extenuating circumstances, though, with the rain we're having, the greens have slowed down, but still, he will be frustrated by that.
Looks simple enough. His chance for 15 under is taken. Hovland. Bit of rain in the air, doesn't make it any easier. And simple stuff for McIntyre.
Only two shots behind, six to play, McIntyre remains very much in the title hunt. But Zach is only one off the pace, now being jointly set by Chanketti and Hovland. The big question at the Estonian Golf and Country Club, who will slip? Who will be the last man standing? The story continues after the break. The International European Amateur Championship provides a showcase for the Estonian Golf and Country Club and for the host nation in general.
There are now 7-18 hole courses in Estonia. We are growing 5-10% a year as a golf nation. Not big in numbers, but in percentage definitely quite good. I think 10-15 years ago the sport was seen more elite sport. Now I think more normal people start the game, and golf is a normal part of society.
Soon to complement the sea course will be the stone course, recrafted by a former ladies world number one.
The stone course is the first course which we opened in 2005, and it will be now redesigned by the European Golf Design and Annika Sørenstam. So it will be full 18-hole course. We hope to open this 2019 or 2020. With a hotel and spa on site. So Estonian Golf and Country Club will be a golf resort with 36 holes and first European course by Annika Sørenstam. I think the course will be very enjoyable, both from the professional side, but also for families, for young children. This is the way Annika thinks, and we like it very much.
It's a location with a bright future. And the same goes for those demonstrating their skills to Daikin.
It does. Now, Robert McIntyre's pushed his tee shot to the left here, being a left-hander on this left-to-right dogleg, 13th. From the second cut of rough, can he get the purchase on the ball and the distance? Well, there's the answer. It's yes. Very well-played shot from the Scot. Lost out in the final, of course, of that amateur championship to Scott Gregory in windy conditions down by the sea at Porthcawl. First view of 21-year-old Kennesaw State Owls man from Georgia, Fredrik Nylén. He is Swedish, of course. 3 under par at the start of the day, 10 under now, having a fantastic last round, Phil.
As is Simon Zach, who's birdied the 14th, and that means Zach, Chanketti, and this man, Victor Hovland, are tied at the top.
Can he get it all the way back to the back plateau? Yes, hang on. Stay there. That's good.
Zach, not bad. The bounce a little fierier than he anticipated. He's got an invitation to play in the D&D Real Czech Masters on the European Tour in a couple of weeks, and he's rounding into form beautifully.
Another great drive from Chanketti on the 13th. You'll fancy this one. Well, I'm lucky not to get a little bit of spin back onto the putting surface there, but it's a good birdie chance nevertheless.
Now, Connor Syme continuing what's been a very consistent season at the top level of the amateur game. I think it's fair to say the weather has been changeable today, Kim, but right now the sun is shining and I think the players are prospering.
Yeah, the rain's gone away. Good to see. Syme taps in. Now, back to the 21-year-old from Gothenburg, Nylén. This for a 64. And to finish 11 under. Oh, no. Probably his worst putt of the day in his own mind. It's a shame, but a great last round, 74, 68, 71 and 65. Sunday best from Frederik Nielen. He can be proud of himself. 10 under in the clubhouse.
Now this for Cianchetti to be the outright leader.
From the right, slightly. Oh, firm and straight. What a putt, what a make.
I think he's really enjoying the experience, and that's how it should be.
Right to left for the 18-year-old from Halmstad. Svensson. Oh, they're all going in now, aren't they? Just when it matters. He moves to 11 under.
So far this week, over on 15, Simon Zak has made two birdies. Oh, but what a shame. The third is not forthcoming. That was a chance blown to join the lead again.
Back to the 13th, and the pressure now on Hovland. He's just seen Cianchetti get one in against the head from off the green. This to match him. Oh, nowhere else, right in the back. You can see what it means to him. Great tussle, this one.
And with Hovland and Cianchetti up to 16 under, all the more important that Robert McIntyre makes this. Only a par. Time and holes, it would appear, running out. Still, McIntyre is one of two Scots currently ensconced in the top five, together with Syme. Zak is third, one shot behind the joint leaders, Hovland and Cianchetti, who I can report gave themselves a little more breathing space with matching birdies on the 14th to reach 17 under. This is turning into a real battle for supremacy. And Kim, with so many ranking points at stake, it's not all about the title.
No, it's about moving up the tables and earning your spurs and getting into all the best elite tournaments as well. This is Peter Launebeek, the Dane, wearing Danish colours, red and white, third shot at the 18th, starting the day at 5 under, and here he is at minus 10. Maybe we'll finish 11 under after that third shot on the par 5. Cianchetti, his third shot on the 15th. It's also a par 5. Work to do there. Now, what about Hovland on the 15th, Phil? It's a par 5. His figures so far on this hole, 4-3-4.
Owns it. 524 metres, so no pushover. Maybe the club just turned around slightly in the grass there. I can't imagine that was an alignment issue.
No, just a little bit of deceleration through the impact and the neck gets caught up in the grass. Now, Launebeek, 72, 69, 70, and a superb clickety-click, 66 on Sunday. Great performance, 11 under.
So Cianchetti to break the deadlock again. A little right to left this. Oh, en route, he must have thought that was in. Just slightly too much pace to take the break.
Every putt absolutely vital now, coming down the stretch. Hovland moves in. He's got a chance for the lead. If this goes in, he'll grab it. Go on. Oh, just didn't fall for him. He's shaved the hole a number of times now. Tough to bear.
The two playing partners both robbed. A joint case of the nears for the joint leaders on the 15th. But Ciancetti and Hovland will have to be content with a two-shot cushion over Zach. Next, the crunch moments from a European amateur championship that's been so well supported in Estonia. Welcome back to the Estonian Golf and Country Club, and welcome back to the 2016 International European Amateur Championship, where the leading contender from Eastern Europe, Simon Zak, suffers a crushing blow to his chances with a bogey on the 17th he could ill afford. The consequence of that untimely mistake, Zak now trails by three from joint leaders Luca Ciancetti and this man, Victor Hovland, who couldn't quite grab a chance for birdie and the outright advantage on the 16th. It means that barring an extraordinary finish from Zak, Robert McIntyre, or a terrible twin collapse from the pace setters, this has pretty much developed into a two-horse race, almost a match play scenario in a stroke play format. And Hovland's arrived on the penultimate tee, hoping to strike a telling blow on the tough par three.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they play this hole, because they're both one over par so far for the 17th. This is Hovland. I'm talking about Hovland and Ciancetti, of course. Second longest of the par threes. On the sea course, 180 metres. He's pulled across that one, hasn't he? Yeah. Tall man, easy to do. Not a hook, just a pull. And he's into the second cut. Lush stuff.
So, as I said, a match play feel and advantage at the moment, Ciancetti.
Can he take advantage? Ooh, flip that one over. That is a hook. That's turning. Hold on. Well, better placed than Hovland. But it's tense stuff.
Quite damp conditions. The 18th is 526 metres. But it does represent a birdie opportunity. Simon Zak. Oh. Disappointing, but one negative in a sea of positives. Four subpar rounds, including a 66 to finish. And, of course, that indelible memory, the hole-in-one on 10.
Yes, and carrying the hopes for Eastern Europe here. That's Svensson. He knows the line here, having watched Zak. It's a left or righter. Stay up. Oh, just about does. And finds the darkness. A second 68 of the week for Svensson. I think this lad is a great prospect, Phil.
Yes, and now off to Muirfield and the Renaissance Club to defend that British boys' title.
Hovland from the lush rough. He knows this stuff. There's plenty of it on his home course at Micklegard. It's a Trent Jones design. But he's got some work to do there.
Now, Connor Syme on 18. Never anywhere else. You mentioned before his home course, Kim Dromoig. Lovely place, halfway between St Andrews and Carnoustie. And the 18th hole there, I can tell you, from personal experience, is one of the tightest I've ever played.
Yes. Syme, a class player as well, led the qualifiers at the Amateur Championship. A couple of 68s at Royal Porthcawl and Pyland Kenfig. That was impressive. Now, Ciancetti, can he put the pressure on Hovland here and get it close? His second shot on the par 317th is not good enough. Yeah, puff of the cheeks. Don't blame him.
Now, up on 18, you might think this is another Italian, given the name. But, Kim, not so.
No, Gianmarco Petrozzi from the Trentum Golf Club. He is English, and he can putt. Good birdie putt there for closing 72. His highest score of the week, but he can be very happy with his performance in the clubhouse at minus nine.
And this is Adrian Moronk, part of the winning Palmer Cup team. Played for Europe at Formby against the USA, the leading collegiate players. And I think we're going to hear an awful lot about him. We know he started today with a seven, but nevertheless, it's going to be a level par round of 72.
Yes, he was bidding to become the first Pole to win the Amateur Championship. Lost out to Scott Gregory, the eventual winner, in the semi-final. Now, Hovland. Very important putt for him. No. Give it a good run, but it's a drop shot at a crucial time. One hole to go. Leaves the door open, Phil, for Signor Cianchetti.
Yes, he's made all of those birdies, but sometimes a par can be just as vital. This for a one-shot lead.
Yes!
He doesn't lack gallery support, Kim.
That was huge. Well done, young man.
Zach leads in the clubhouse, but surely the trophy is between Cianchetti, now leading after that tenacious par, or Hovland, one adrift and forced to attack on the last.
Well, Hovland likes this hole. He's had two birdies so far this week. He's right on the limit here of his three wood. Needs a huge hit, and he's given it one. Can he find the green? Urging it on. Can he do it? Oh, not quite. Very good shot, though.
And slightly lengthier off the tee. Cianchetti can get there.
Keep your tempo going. Oh, he hasn't. He's completely stopped on that. It's got to go right. And pray. Oh, Phil. Lush grass, downhill. Not nice.
What, though, is the incentive for winning this title, apart from the kudos? Joining names like this on the trophy. Four Ryder Cup is there, and including a former world number one in McIlroy. And, of course, a place at Royal Birkdale next year in the Open Championship.
All down, then, to the last hole. Or maybe extra holes. Cianchetti, 60-degree wedge. And he's fluffed it. He's caught it too heavy. Nervous times now.
And suddenly Hovland must be thinking, up and down for a birdie, and I could snatch this in regulation play.
Can he get it close? Not too difficult, this shot. Onto the putting surface first bounce, let it run out. No, he's short. That's disappointing. Still anyone's title.
To bear in mind, though, Cianchetti's mind must be whirring.
Yeah, and the ball's lying down as well. Still out with the 60 degree, though. Give that a big hit. That's clumsy. My word, he's there for four.
Well, if the mind was whirring beforehand, it's doing double overtime now.
Advantage, Hovland. I think. Yes, Cianchetti has not lost his turn. It's for a very unlikely par. He's one ahead, remember? And that's not dead either.
Wow. Suddenly, Hovland has a putt to win.
I bet he can't believe it. Overnight leader, of course, but this man from Italy has played the best golf of the day up until now. Right, for a 68, and to win the International European Amateur Championship. Give it a chance. Oh, no. I thought he was aiming a bit left there. Well, just a par then, if he taps in, which he'll wait.
And while all of this drama is going on, the forgotten man is Robert McIntyre.
For the par. And does it. 68. Could have been better. But a good week.
Now for Cianchetti, the biggest test of his life. That needed some guts.
Oof. A six at the last. Letting this man in. And with a little par putt, we're into extra time, Phil.
Now, I'm sure you'll agree, that was nervy in the extreme. And the tension is far from over. Extraordinary stuff. Extraordinary finish. 72 holes not sufficient to separate the Italian and the Norwegian. And when the scorecards were signed, it was back out for a three-hole aggregate score playoff to determine the identity of the champion. The first hole nominated the par 3 10th, where Cianchetti tried to deliver the initial thrust. This for birdie. One hole played, Cianchetti one clear, but the 11th proved very different. Hovland safely made par, but his rival was struggling. The bogey all square, so to the third extra hole, and Hovland's birdie putt to triumph.
Open stance again, aiming down the left side, and he's hit it there, but he can't believe it. Just not got the line right on that one again.
Still inseparable. I can tell you the fourth extra hole was halved in par. So on we go, and of course it's now sudden death.
The 11th. Hovland's second shot on this par four. People are clapping already, and it's a superb effort. Will that be the clincher?
Well, Cianchetti birdied this hole in regulation play a couple of hours ago. Can he duplicate that?
No way. That is outrageous. Remember, Hovland is in close. That's a body blow. Wow. Gulp. Focus. Believe. Oh, well done. It wasn't long, but it was huge in importance. That's to keep it going, Phil.
Just incredible stuff. The marathon continues, and when the next was halved in pars, it was over to the seventh extra hole, the par 3 10th here on the sea course, where Cianchetti is a little nearer.
Great for the spectators. Hovland for the birdie. No. Can't be short now. It's all about initiative now. And he may have handed it over to Cianchetti. To win then. No, he's up out of it early. He knew he'd pushed it.
Indeed, but as it was two holes ago, Hovland must now hole a very tricky putt indeed to keep this contest alive.
Yes, and in playoffs, you don't want to see somebody lose it with a bogey. You want to see somebody take it with a birdie. So here we go again. Stay focused, back and through. Firm putt, come on. No. He's missed it. It's all over. Anticlimax for him. Joy for the Azzurri.
What a pity, though, for Hovland, who contributed so much to the championship. But for the second year in succession, it's the Italians celebrating, and in good voice at the closing ceremony, as their green, white and red flag is flying the proudest and the highest, and the silverware is presented to an overjoyed 21-year-old.
It's a good victory. It's been a great week, and it means a lot because I will play the British Open. It's an unbelievable sensation. I never played a match like this, and it was really tough because Victor was really good and he played really good golf. But it was a great fight, and I enjoyed it, and it was unbelievable to me.
Luca Cianchetti, ecstatic in Estonia and Birkdale bound as the 2016 International European Amateur Champion.